Both Scala and Java have single inheritance, and as opposed to C++ with multiple inheritance, for instance. And instead of Java's interface, Scala has a similar but more powerful concept called a trait. And the trait can also contain code and attributes. So let's see a simple example. Here we have this object class, and well, we create a new object of type C. What happens there? C extends A, which takes a parameter. So this is a must be a class. And then we want this function from B. So we can use the trait B, since it takes no parameter. I mean, a trait cannot have a parameter. Okay, and then when we do this constructor, it will just set the attribute and nothing else will happen. And then when we come to the hello method, that one is from C, so it will call hi from B, which will print hello. Okay, and then we use by from A, and it will print the attribute, which was a parameter. Okay.